This is Danica, and in this video, we're gonna continue on the custom LearnDash listing that we did last time. So if you could remember, we created this one, the custom LearnDash listing, so that whenever you have a specific design in mind, we have built and like showed in the last video how you could do that using JetEngine and its listing functionality, and of course with the Elementor Pro. So now on the last listing, we were able to put some label in here. If, like example, if the course is in progress or not started, and some indicator that they do have access to that course. But I got this question from one of my subscribers, and she asked how to create or have this listing, the custom listing, but then only list those courses that the login member has access or is enrolled to. So in this video, we're gonna build on that one. And so to do that, we actually need to create a custom query for it to work. Now, if we check the database info from LearnDash Docs, they said they're using the user activity and also the LearnDash user activity meta. They also explained and show some example how you could like use it. Now for this one, since we are using JetEngine in its listing, and then based on the data here, we're gonna take advantage on the data under LearnDash user activity. So we're gonna use this table, and we're also gonna use the WP underscore post to grab some ID. So how this will look is an example here. This is a very plain listing, but I only have access to the course one. I'm only enrolled to the course one in my example here, and you can confirm that in here. Now if I example add another course and then refresh this, I now have course one and two. Now if I remove a course, save that, and since in this demo site, I'm not using any payment processor to determine how the member got deactivated or unenrolled from that course, then I'm gonna just manually do the syncing in here. But if you are using like WooCommerce or different one, then we could also add that in our query so that we don't need to do this manually. But in my case here, I'm just using the plain LearnDash, nothing add-ons for the purchase, so I needed to do that. But if I refresh now, it's back, and I only have access and I'm only enrolled to course one. That's why it's just showing the course one. So how do we do this? Let's start creating the query builder under JetEngine. Okay, so here's the query that I did, and we're gonna create a new one so that I could like show you how to do your own. So I'm just gonna create a new one in here. Now, when creating a query, JetEngine allows you to call or grab some data from different sources. So it could be a post query, terms query, user query, and so on. But for this case, we're gonna do the SQL query because we're gonna need to grab the post and the LearnDash user activity query and query that for our purpose in here. So I'm gonna do here SQL query, and of course you need to name your query. So in my case, I'm gonna do my courses. And then here, since courses in LearnDash is still a post, then we're gonna need to start from that. We can't start from this table. It should be post. So we're gonna grab the post. And then since there are two tables here that we are grabbing some data, the post, so if this is your SQL, we have the WP post, and for the LearnDash purpose, they record their members or their users' progress under the user activity. So we're gonna also call that. Now to call more than one table for the SQL query, you need to use the join functionality in here. And let me just do a preview results so that you can see how this sidebar changed. So I'm gonna do join table, and I'm gonna do an inner join, and I'm gonna call the LearnDash underscore user underscore activity table. And then for this one, it should be, it's gonna ask you which data is similar. So you need to find that. In LearnDash case, the course ID is exactly similar to the post ID. So we're using that. Now that we have this to join, the post and the LearnDash user activity, we're now gonna filter this query. So the first one is post status. So we want the post status to be only those published. So you change, you can see that the result count now changed to 31. So that's the first one. Next is we're gonna do the activity type. If you're gonna check the table here, there's an activity type and it says access, and it has some user ID and also course and post ID. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do the LearnDash user activity type is equals to access, and then as you can see here on the side, we can find that here, activity type access. Now I also want just to do or to grab the post type courses. So I'm gonna copy this one, post type, and I'm gonna add that in my filter. So I'm gonna do post and then find the post type. Let's find that. Here is equals to just the courses. So as you can see, the result is now 2. Now I think what's missing is, last but not the least, is we need to make sure that this is based, the data is based on the current login number. So we need to find the LearnDash user ID. And that data is exactly what we could see here. So it says here that the user ID 1 has access to this course. So that's what it means. So we're gonna do that, and then we're gonna do equals, and then it should be the current user ID. So now I only have 1, and that data is exactly the same to what you could see if you edit your profile and see which course you are only enrolled to. Since I'm an admin, then of course it's gonna be based on my data here because I'm the user that's currently logged in this website right now. So that's how you create basically your query. And of course, you could do an order. What I do is post ID, and I just leave that default and post ID. Yep. So that it orders like course 1, 2, and 3 and so on. So that's the purpose of that one. Now, after creating your query, you need to create a listing based on that query. So if you're gonna check my listing here, so it now says course listing template 1. This is my list that I'm using in here. So what I'm doing is I notice that I need to use the dynamic field from JetEngine, and I'm gonna show you what I mean. So if I just grab, let's just say, because in my past video I used this headline or heading, and then if I just do post title, it seems like it doesn't work. Not sure why, but it doesn't work. So I need to grab the dynamic, the one from JetEngine, dynamic field, maybe because it is a query, and I need to do that and grab, as you can see here, it's post title and it's showing properly. So let's just create a new query so that you could see how this works. So if we go to JetEngine listing and adding a new one, it says post, it should be a query builder because it is based on that query result that we just created. So now we have the query builder, and we're gonna select which query it is gonna pull data. So as if you could remember, the one that we did is the my courses, this one. So again, let's do add new query builder and select that query. You could name this anything you want. And then here, again, you can't use this. It doesn't pull that data. I'm not really sure why. It says new my courses, so it's pulling the query name or the listing name instead. So we're gonna need to do the dynamic field post title. So let's just do maybe 300, so it's much easier. So for this one, and then you could still style it exactly similar to how you could do in the heading, so it's fine. But do note that I noticed that one. And then let's grab maybe the image, and then let's just save this and see how it looks. So I'm gonna change this listing, and I am just gonna grab a listing, and then here I'm gonna select that new my courses, and then you could remove this because it's now basing on the query that you created. Now do note that if you watched my previous video, there were lots of options in this section here, but now it's gone, and the new version of JetEngine removed that one, and what they recommend is to create your query from the query builder rather than from here. So you should, and highly recommend, you deactivate that and create your query properly in the query builder. So I'm gonna call my query here, and then publish. So it's also just showing the course one. If example, I enroll to course two, let's see if that works. So course two is also in here. Now, how do you add a link just like what we've done? So to add a link, you need to use the dynamic field. I'm not sure if the JetEngine button could pull the link properly. I haven't tried that yet for the query builder, but for this one, so what I do is I use the dynamic field, and then I do post ID, and then under filter field output, I'm gonna say get the post or page link, and then here you could, this is the value, so you could do the post page link. You could also do embeddable URL. You could also, I think what I've done is I have used the get post or page URL, and what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna, I hope you could see my screen. Okay, so I have wrapped this with an HF, or maybe you could also do a button. Something like that, and then update, and then let's check. So if I hover over or maybe click, I'm now in course two and then course one. So you could play with the builder, and I think I suggest you stick with the dynamic field when building this custom list. So you could still design it to look exactly the same to the button or whatever you have in your custom listing. But for this My Courses list, you just need to add more styling in here or even additional CSS for this case. So I hope this video helps and it answered your questions for how to create a custom My Courses listing. It's a bit different to what we originally did in the last video, but because it is pulling two tables, then we actually just need to create the query builder and create your listing from that one. Again, thanks for your support. I really appreciate it. And click that subscribe and bell button so that I get you notified whenever I post tutorials like this. And yep, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.